Welcome back, guys. I'm pleased to be able to say that I think you guys enjoyed the last episode as much as I enjoyed making it. It was pretty freaking awesome, wasn't it? Now, this episode is going to be different because, quite frankly, my brain is fried. Like, totally fried. So this episode is going to be, we're going to look at a bunch of things. It's going to be relatively chill. I'm going to show you some problems that I've fixed. We're going to look at the planes and the airports. We're going to look at some optimization because we need to make some more money, amazingly enough. And we're going to do some upgrades and we'll look at the regional lines and we're going to get some more production going. So yeah, freaking loads of things. And I will no doubt digress and wander about and do all kinds of things that I never planned on doing and not do any of the things that I actually supposed to do. Because that's the way it is. Why have I got these three trains over here? Let's start with that. The TGV line, as many of you pointed out, was broken. One of the trains was flipped around. So we've got like four trains all backed up. So I've actually been playing around with the signals so that I took out some signals at the beginning so it'll help to space the trains out when they finally get to their destination and stuff. So hopefully the TGV should be back on track fairly soon, which will be a good thing because that'll bring us in some cash. These three trains over here, I've also put a bunch of signals in here because, as again, several of you commented, not enough signals down here. In fact, there were no signals down here. And that's because I just didn't have time, guys. I mean, it was, I didn't get the video out last night till what, like, I don't know, like after 1 o'clock in the morning. So yeah, I'm going to. I just rushed. It was a rush. What can I say? Like, I'm trying to come up with a clever excuse. I don't have a clue. I had to rush it just to get it done and get it out. Right, these three trains are in weird places. This is supposed to be on the Halo line. If I bring up the line so you can actually see the lines. Yeah, let's put it down there. And we go and see where this train is. This train is currently on the Applejack line. So he's actually going to wander into this station and then go over here and get back onto the line that he's supposed to be going onto. Train 35 is currently sitting in this station. And oh, no, yeah. Oh, no, yeah, because that's a. No. Hang on a second. Train 35. Oh, yeah. That's train 35, which is currently on this line. And of course, it should be on the oil line. So I've put in a couple of switches. Well, put in a couple of switches here so that he can get back onto his line. So that's fixed. And train 36. Train 36 is sitting in here. So. But there are already some switches, I think, to allow him to get back to the track that he's supposed to be going to. I've been through all of the trains on the main lines, and those were the only three that were a problem, so they'll all be sorted out. Right, what should we look at next? Good point. Don't know. I was going to do some naming, but no, I'll show you this first because this is just funny. This will make you smile. So, the airports. Now, we haven't upgraded the planes for a while. Now, amazingly, look at this. This is carrying like 14 of 21 passengers, which is actually pretty good. But then I zoomed in and look at this. And this is just going to make you smile. Would you ride on this plane? frankly, I wouldn't. I would be like, do you mind if I catch the next one? Because, oh my god, that is a mess, isn't it? Holy hell. Yeah. So, I think we need some new planes. And it is an opportunity to just, like, see some of the new planes. Because we got new planes. In fact, we haven't done a lot with the whole planes for a while. We've got 757s and we've got Airbus 320s, which is kind of cool. So, what's one of the passengers? 38 capacity on that. Oh, 55 on the 757s. I don't think we really need 757s, but we'll probably have them. We'll keep our couple of Concords flying, although I wonder what state they're in. They're probably a freaking mess as well. Okay, now, I need to put in a fourth airport. Should we do that? Should we do that? Yeah, let's do that. I'm going to do that bit of naming first because I want to, basically. Yeah, let's do it from there. What the hell? So let's see. I'm just going to name some of the Halo trains. Only a few. Like, I don't know. Three or four, but I want to get these done. I would love to name all of them. But it's like, it's time. You know, everything's time. So Train 21. Train 21's no longer going to be Train 21. Do you remember Quinton Quill? QQ? Quinton from the Rimworld series. Well, Quinton wanted to be in, so this is going to be the QQ Express. There we go. There you go, Quinton. And let's do one over here. Now, this was Mia Froberg. Frequent commenter. Fairly frequent commenter. I'd like to see more comments from her. I'd like to see more comments from all of you. She's from Finland. And she wanted something for the Finnish people. So, the Finlandia. Ah, there you go. The Finlandia. Running around on Halo Trans 2. Oh, that's going to please all the Finnish. Now I'm going to have every other nationality saying, why don't we have a train? What else? Oh, now, Bickety Bam. Bickety Bam's always got an opinion about everything, right? And he was saying about the TGV. Let's kind of look at the TGV. I can't remember whether I named the TGV trains. If I didn't, then we're going to name some of the TGV. Where the hell's the TGV? It's right down here. TGV. Let's have a look. Now, they haven't got names at the moment. Now, Train 69's staying. Train 69 to dogging. But we're gonna name a couple of the others. And he thought, this is his idea of naming these after me and Nanny Giggles, right? He wanted this one called, if I actually go there. He wanted this one called The Beauty. And he wanted this one called, yes, you've guessed it, The Beast. And frankly, I'm not happy about this, right? You can't refer to Nanny Giggles as The Beast. It's just wrong. I'm sorry, Bickety, it's just wrong. Okay, we might do more pairings like that. He came up with some other ones like Bill and Ben, the Flowerpot Men, and Bert and Ernie and stuff like that. We might do that with more of the trains. I don't know. Several people, by the way, have been asking about, you know what, I might let this run. I'm just going to let this run on a little bit. Keep an eye on these and see where they're going and are they getting onto the right tracks and stuff. It'd be nice. Train 49 has reached its lifetime and should be replaced. Ah, now this is something that we need to do. So let's keep that up there. What was I talking about? I don't even freaking remember now. I told you, my brain is like totally fried. I've got almost 300 hours in this game. Can you believe that? I couldn't believe it. But apparently it's true. It says so on Steam. You're going to move, train, like any time in the next like 6 months? What are you waiting for? I'm waiting for this to be free. Well, that train's pulled out of the station, so you should be moving. Oh, now you're moving. I think we need maybe some more signals in here to speed things along a little bit, because the trains are a bit backed up. We've got a train sitting here, train sitting down here. Mind you, I've only just put a load of signals in, so hopefully it should actually speed things up a bit. We'll see. I was actually going to start this episode off with a time lapse of Bickety's Hollow growing after I smashed it all to bits, because you can see it's grown like a hell of a lot. If you want me to do just a little time lapse, it'll be like, I don't know, a minute or something, but a quick time lapse showing from when it was all smashed to bits growing back to its full glory as it is now, let me know, and I'll maybe throw it in at the beginning of the next video or something. Now, I did want to put a road going down here, but because I kind of want to link that up, but it's kind of difficult with the terrain. Now, I'm just wondering if we could put like a bit of a loopy road in. Oh, train 50 has reached its lifetime. That's train 49, so I'm guessing this is the other train that's on the Ice Cream CM. Yeah, well, what a surprise. Let's drag you over there. So look, before I do, you know what, before I do this, let's see if I can get rid of these trains. So let's bring up the lines. Oh, right, yeah, you're just heading onto there. So you're good to go. Excellent. Let's have a look at train 35. Train 35. What are you doing on that line, train 35? And in fact, what the hell is the oil line doing going through there? And this one's going through there. That's kinda weird. In fact, what the hell? What the hell is going on with that? That's going... Oh, no, that's right. That's just going around by Troy. That's actually correct. But that's on the wrong track. Which is, that's the one we're looking at. Yeah, you've got a long way to go to be able to get back on the right track. Unless I put a quick sneaky bit of track that there's absolutely no freaking chance of me getting it in there, is there? There's a signal down there. Maybe I can avoid it. Oh, hang on a sec. Oh. Too much curvature and there's a collision. It's because there's that signal there. Let's see if we could do this, because it'd be kind of nice to get the trains back on the proper tracks. It would help with our profitability as well, which would be a very good thing. Yes. Hooray. Cha-ching. Nah, no. Bonehead. Try that again. There we go. Now, come on. Oh, please. Ah. It's going to remove a building. Don't care about that. We haven't knocked any buildings down for at least 5 minutes, so. So that should... Oh, you... Why didn't you go that way? What the hell? What? Seriously, why didn't that go that way? You stupid train, you. I put in a nice bit of track and you don't go the right way. Okay, what can we do? I could try reversing it. And then try it again. Let's reverse you up a little bit. Make sure you're clear of that switch. Switch you around again. I bet it still won't go. Come on. You've got a nice path there to get back on... Oh, yes, now it's going. Hooray. You know what? We'll let that go down then. Am I going to delete that switch? I don't know. I might leave that switch in. What the hell? Yeah, what the hell? Why not? So train 35 is back on its right track. And train 36... Train 36 is back on track. Hooray. All of our trains are on the right tracks. Right. Okay, what are we going to do next? So I've done my name. Yeah, I've done Quinton, and I've done Merya Froberg. I hope it's about, is it pronounced Merya? Let me know. By the way, a lot of people have said, oh my God, that looks like the, I've got to get the pronunciation on this, like, as close as I can. This is, Liège station. And it's actually, Liège-Gulmain station. And it is. This is a real world station. It's not like a figment of somebody's imagination. This is a real station, and apparently, it's freaking awesome. And let's face it, if it does look like this, which it does, then yes, it is freaking awesome. So there you go. That's that. Right. Let's. We can let that run on slow. So it's kind of more fun when it's running, isn't it? Yeah, of course it is. Right. What are we going to do next? We're going to have a look at the profit situation. Oh, now one other thing I need to tell you about. Is Confused Food and Ice Cream Town, the freight trains, both the Halo Freight and the Halo Oil, were not stopping at the Ice Cream and Confused Food stations. And I fixed that, so now they are. Now, like, Confused Food was like, look, it's all zeros for delivering stuff. But now it's back to, now it should start getting deliveries of stuff. It'll take a little bit of time, but... It'll get there. Another thing I want to show you. I told you this was all going to be blooming digressions and me all over the place. I wasn't wrong, was I? Right, let's have a look. Pickety's Hollow. Look at this. Population's up. Oh my god, population's up to 4,700. That's going to be close to being our biggest city. Let's have a look. Oh, it's almost. It's number two. So that's grown by like 1,000 since the beginning of the last episode. Wow. So yeah, redeveloping it like this has really made it fly. Massive, massive city. The amazing thing is, if I turn the icons on, for like the bus stops and stuff, our passenger transport system in here is awesome. It's moving all the people, and you can see that the queue here is starting to go down as well. I mean, this was up at like, what, 1,000? And now, down to like 371. So that's peachy, that's awesome. I was going to put that bit of road in. I was going to put a bendy bit of road in. And of course, we'll call this like Jamie Lee Curtis Street. Because it's going to have awesome curves. That's a throwback to my old SimCity series. And a lot of, several people have commented that, you know, this is kind of like back to the old SimCity days. And it really is, isn't it? So what I was thinking was a road that maybe goes like up here. Like kind of this and then kind of winds like up there. So let's see what we can do. Is that max? Yeah, that's up as far as it'll go. And I don't know, something like that. And then connect up to there. Hooray! Yeah, that'll do. There we go. Jamie Lee Curtis Street. And I think we'll just leave it. Well, will we leave it just as a small street, or are we going to upgrade it to a medium? I suppose we could probably upgrade it to a medium. I don't know. What do you think? Small street? Should we just have it as a little small street? Yeah, let's have it as a little small street. It's fine. I just wanted the connection, really, more than anything. All right. What are we going to do next? Next, let's have a look at... hang on a second. I showed you the population. Let's have a look. Who's top for shopping facilities? Lanceburg Heights, still. Sparksville, Futerville. I'm hoping that Confusedford and Ice Cream Town will start climbing the list a little bit now that we've hooked them up to the freight system again. And Winniston, Sparksville, Rootborough. Ice Cream Town is way up there on the jobs, which is kind of good too. Yeah, Maceley's kind of up there. Confusedford. Because Hollow's still a bit down. Needs to grow. Needs to grow with the old industry and the commerce. All right. Now, there are a couple of things that we actually need to do, like profitability-wise. So, let's pause this for a second. And what we're going to do is we're going to do a little bit of optimization, I think. I was doing the freaking airports, wasn't I? Should I do the airports first before I do this? I don't know. I'm still trying to figure out where to put the other airport. We've got Wendover here. I'm thinking, like, somewhere over here and have, like, links from Sparksville and Barrington and Viewterville and Wendover. So I'm thinking somewhere kind of in here. The thing is, it's not that far from Rogi. It's a fair distance from somewhere else. And where's the other one? Not Winniston. And from Dogging over there. So yeah, I'm thinking it's going to go in here. Somewhere. Like, God only knows where. Let's do this, I suppose. Do I do this now? You know what? We'll put it in. I'm not going to hook up all the stuff to it. But we'll put it in. So where the hell's it going to go? It's going to go somewhere over here. And this is going to be RAF Halton. So let's... I don't know. We haven't destroyed anything for 2 minutes, so we'll knock some of this down. Let's see. I'm thinking of some kind of, I don't know, maybe even like a tram route connecting these four. Might be kind of cool. I don't know, maybe even link them in somehow, I don't know. Or maybe have a little mini route over here or something. I don't know. I don't really know a lot today. So what happens when your brain's fried. So let's see. We want a two runway airport. We've got two runway airports now. So we can upgrade our other airports. What the hell am I trying to do? I'm trying to flip it around. Now, where are you going to go in? I'm going to put it in where it's kind of flattest. It's pretty flat over there. How about there? If you put it there? Well, that's where it's going to be put, so it's what it is. We'll hook it up for now with just a small country road, just so that it's connected. What are we using? Mediums? Not medium street, medium country road. Darn it. Let's bring you in there and just hook you up to there. That needs to be reconnected. Okay, cool. I need to talk to you about another change that they've made. Make a note. Change. Alerts. So if I don't write it down, then I'll just completely forget. And I actually want to get through this. So yeah, I've got to do those. Okay, so I've put that in. Now the reason I'm putting this in, and I didn't freaking upgrade it. I'm going to bun it. Three terminals and two runways. Yeah, no, I've got to change that. Let's continue. There we go. Apply. Cha-ching. All right. So, just run that around the outside. Oh, come on. Go straight, please. Oh, what the hell is wrong with you? Thank you. Not very good at doing S-curves, that's the only thing. They do need to do something about that, because I do like a nice S-curve. There we go. Alright. Now, I just wanted to throw that in, because I just want to do the routes. I want the planes going around, like, in a proper route. Like I said I was going to do, God knows how many episodes ago. So, let's see. Is that a Concorde? Oh, let's have a look what Concorde looks like when it's been neglected for a long time. Oh my god. That's just not right. We need replacement Concorde. Concorde should look gleaming and beautiful. Oh well. Now let's see. I do want the Concorde line up. And any other planes around? Let's go over here. Find another plane. Here we go. You. That'll do. Alrighty. So, currently it just goes around, let's see. God, where's it go? It's difficult to see that green line. So it goes round here and lands in there. See, you know what? That needs to be the other way around. That really needs to be the other way around. Because the planes are coming in and landing that way. It'd be so much better if they came in and just landed that way and then took off and went straight over there rather than having to take off that way and go that way. Wouldn't it? It really, really would. Oh, some rework. Yeah, because we haven't had enough rework. We're not playing there at the moment. Yeah, that definitely needs to get turned around. I'm just wondering, like, do I do it? Probably now is as good a time to do it as any, actually. Go on then. Go on, let's do it. Let's do it. What the hell? Actually do something in this episode. So, we'll dig this out. Get rid of the depot. Get rid of that. Oh, that was not what I wanted it to do. Oh, yes. Stupid game. What do I want? I want bus line, yes. Electric, yes. I want extra large street. Fancy them going into the bloomin' airport. It's just silly. Now, I want to get rid of this, but I can't because of this plane. So, I've now got to let this run. Hope that this plane takes off before another plane lands. Come on, get the hell out of there. Go away. There we go. Pause. Right, now we can actually get rid of that. Good. And we can get rid of this. Oh, I've got to get rid of my nice bridge. I spent time putting that nice bridge in. God, there's always something. There's always something. Let's push you right back over there. In fact, we might as well push this right back to here, because we'll be running the trams. Well, what the hell did I just destroy? I think I just destroyed a building by accident. What I want is for the trams to come, obviously, on the south side rather than on the north side. So, okay, so it was there. I've got to put that station back in as well. Try and remember that. So you are going to be three terminals and a large airport this time. And collision. Oh, there's that little bit of road there. Let's get rid of that little bit of road so that we can do this properly. Get you out of there. Right, airport. I don't know. I'm thinking probably about there. I'd actually like it a bit further up, but it's not doing very nice things to the terrain over there. I don't know. Like, there would be better. That's coming quite a bit south, but yeah, that's where it's going to have to go. If I move it, I don't know, about there. Yep. Cha-ching, it's in. Right. Now, why didn't you pick up that? Too far away, I guess. Okay. All right, well. We'll rename this to somewhere else airport. Somewhere else airport. Boom. And so we've got to change those. So instead of going there, we're going to go to here and get rid of that completely. Yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in two lines so that they just go round the square. So we'll have a clockwise and an anti-clockwise route around the square. But look how the lines have sorted themselves out. Right, so that it just flies straight in here and then straight out. Now that will save a lot of time, and it's all about time. It's all about journey time, and I've come to the conclusion that with the airports and the same with anything. It doesn't matter whether it's the you're thinking about the Concorde or the TGV or just a regional route compared with a regional train route compared with a bus route. It's all about the journey time. You've got people who will take the cheaper option, the cheaper, slower option, and you've got people who will take the faster option. But the faster option has to be faster, right? So I don't know exactly how this works, and I'd love to talk to the developers, and I might even try to talk to the developers, because I'd love to know the answers to this. Right, when they work out their journey time to get from Bickerdy's Hollow, let's say they want to go from Bickerdy's Hollow to Premier 2 Caton. Right now, they can either catch the Halo line, right, or they can get on the TGV, catch the TGV over to Dogging, and then come back to Premier 2 Caton on the Halo line. But what do they factor into their journey? Right, do they factor in like the walking distance to get to a bus stop, then the bus journey to the railway station, then the TGV ride, right, and then walking from the TGV to, well, no, they don't really have to walk. Well, I suppose it's a little walk to the Halo, and then the Halo journey, and then walking to the bus stop, catching the bus, and then walking to their ultimate destination. Does it factor in the whole thing? Because if it does, then the proximity of your bus stations to the train station becomes really important, because if you think about it, the walking time to walk, for example, from here all the way up to here, right, is in terms of the journey time really significant. So for example, when putting an airport in, like this one that we've just put in, the walking time from whatever transport system they've used to get to the airport, walking from there to the airport, you want that to be as close as possible, right? To get more people to take the airports and make the route as fast as possible, you want to make sure that access to the airport is as fast as possible by all the various transport routes. So yeah, it's kind of a big deal. And see, I'm looking at this now and thinking, you know, I could have scrapped those trams and actually got the this regional train to stop at somewhere else airport. You know, I'm just wondering if I could route this around the airport. I might end up doing that, because a train route to the airport would be kind of cool. And maybe we even put like an express on it, like get a really fast train on there to whiz round. Would encourage people to use the airport. Okay. Anyway, we're walking. So we get the line over to Dogging. So we want to change that line to add in our new airport. Now Dogging needs to be upgraded, doesn't it? Yes, it does. So you need to be upgraded to. Oh, good grief. Okay. All right, well, let's do... of course, now I've got my new terrain brush. I was just thinking, oh, my God, that's going to take hours. But now it's not going to take hours. Let's crank it up to higher. There we go, and... that terrain up there. Oh God, I can't tell you how long it took me to blend this into the terrain. God, I wish I'd had this terrain brush then. That's just right. I think that might go in now. Let's see. Upgrade, 3 terminals, 2 runways. Nope. No, it still needs to come up a little bit more. Go. Right. Surely that should do it. No, really? What is it? It must be this bit here. Around here. It's gotta be. Oh, there we go. I should have left it up before, shouldn't I? Makes it much easier. It's still saying it's upset, though. I wonder if we've got collision over here, and I'm thinking maybe we do. Alright, well... What do you want? You want that to be lower there. Okay, so let's drop that terrain down. Let's drop the brush down a little bit. Oh no, see, now it's saying it would have to increase that. Yeah, okay, so it wasn't that. This is going to be fussy. This is going to be very fussy. Let's not complain about that. I'm just wondering if I am going to have to take the freaking road out. And it is kind of looking like it, isn't it? Alright, let's take that out. Now I'm going. There we go. All right, apply, cha-ching. Now, seriously, why did that road have to be removed? These terrain collisions are a little bit annoying sometimes. All right, extra large road we want, bus lane and tram tracks. So you go back in there, sweet. You go back in there, boom, and we're done, and everybody's happy. Okay, so we come into there, and then we want to go around to the new airport, which I didn't actually name, and I need to. So let's rename this to RAF. Well, let's get rid of that first. RAF Halton. There we go. RAF Halton. Hooray! It's in. But yeah, we need transport to it. It's not going to do a whole hell of a lot at the moment. So let's say we go dogging, and then we want to add station. Now, yeah, that's coming in the right way. Excellent. In fact, it's coming in this way and taking off that way. Excellent. Excellent. And I wonder if we can upgrade this. I don't know. We might be able to upgrade this one. Let's see. Nope. That's crazy that it's upset about that. Okay, well, let's... It's just that little bit of road. Why is it upset about that bit of road? Crazy, isn't it? All right, let's pop you in. And we'll re-hook you up. Just needs a little regular bit of road. There we go. Let's take bus lane off and tram off. There we go. Cool. Yay! So we've now got like a square route for those. Now we've got one Concorde going that corner to that corner. Do we have a Concorde going from this corner to that corner? I think that's what we do. Yeah, I think that's what we do. Right, we want a new line. So let's put in a new line. Let's close that down. So new line. So. And we've got this. So this is going clockwise, isn't it? So this won't be 737. This will be AB. Let's call it A. AP clockwise. AP. Air passenger. Now there is a cargo mod, but I'm not risking it at the moment. I might have a play around with it. We'll see. But I'm not risking it at the moment because I've got too much invested in this. So this is going to be anti-clockwise. Cool. So let's see. How many planes we got on here? Three. I'm thinking we have like a couple of planes on. I don't know. Having added the third and upgraded them to two runways, we could probably have three on each, couldn't we? Yeah, I think we could probably afford to have three on each. All right, well, let's do that then. So this is going to go from... Oh, I need to add in this one, don't I? Oh, no, I did that one. So, yeah. So this is going to go RAF Halton, then dogging, then to somewhere else, and then over to Rogie. Boom. All right, cool. All going the right way and stuff. I think so. Right, what should we make you? Should we make you like, I don't know, like blue so we can actually see it? Alright, cool. So what we need to do now is, first thing we need to do is upgrade these. So let's see. What do we want? AP, right at the top. Right at the top. God, I've got so many lines now. It's crazy. So these three... We want to upgrade those. Oh, no. What the hell am I doing? Replacement. Idiot. We want to replace these at 25%. And what are we going to go? We're going to go for Airbuses. I mean, I don't think we're going to be able to cope with that capacity yet. So I think we'll put the Airbuses in at the moment. If we can actually get this profitable, then we'll go for some 757s. Does that sound like a plan? Yeah, can you live with that? All right, let's do that. Loading on that is 7 times. Loading on that is 10 times. Wow. All right. Well, we'll go with Airbuses at the moment. Yeah. This is going to be expensive. What are we doing? So we're going to replace with Airbuses. Automatic, yes. So that's that. Then we want to actually buy some. So let's buy... let's buy one there. And... Where did it go? There it is. you are going to go on to AP anti-clockwise. And then we'll go over here and buy another one. What do I want that? Buy aircraft, Airbus, buy set line, and it clockwise. I just spotted it. You will have been shouting at me, no doubt. Anti-clockwise. There we go. So that's two. We want one more. Where should we put the other one on? Let's put it on over. Let's put it somewhere else. Is that a good idea? And we want one of those. Buy and set line anti-clockwise. There we go. Right. Shall we watch one of these planes? Yes, of course we should. Let's just get those out of the way. Somebody actually did tell me how to minimise them. I've no idea. How to minimise them. No idea. I'll figure it out afterwards, don't worry. Okay, so that's just taken off, which is unfortunate. But we've got one of them coming out here. So let's run it and let's see what happens. Oh. Eversafe 320. Although I have to say, I don't think this is like the prettiest plane that's ever been made. Like, I don't like the nose. It's a bit snub-nosed. You know what I mean? I should talk quietly because we don't want it to hear us, because it'll be upset. No, you're a very pretty plane. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what you think. I don't know. That nose shape just isn't attractive, is it? I mean, if that was on a girl in a bar, you wouldn't go and talk to her, would you? Come on, be fair. But the rest of it, not bad at all. I was going to get into so much trouble then. Fortunately, I spotted what I was going to say, and I stopped myself. Shut up, Skye. This doesn't really... doesn't blend with this colour scheme particularly well. I might switch to my other one. Where are we? Yeah, I want this, and I want logo. And let's go to that one for a bit. There we go. Skystorm. Oh, here we go. Strap yourselves in. Try tables in the upright position. Seatbelts fastened. Oh, and he almost ripped the toilets out the back. I think he very close to over-rotating there, I think. I really want to make the airplanes work because the airplanes are just fantastic. The way they've implemented the airplanes is just brilliant. Look at that, he's actually got full flaps at the moment. Look, the flaps are going up. Look at that. Okay. Make sure Gangu has connected to the state network. Okay, where's Gangu Halt? I have no idea where Gangu Halt is. Oh, here we go. It's actually somewhere else airport. It's not Gangu Halt. Yeah, we need to hook this up, don't we? Yeah, and we need to do it because of the trams as well. It'd be kind of a good idea. So we want extra large country road. We want bus lanes, yes, electric for the trams. And bring it down like that kind of thing. Bring it into there. And now we're going to want a nice bridge over here. So how about we bring you out? Oh, seriously? What the hell's wrong with you? Oh, there we go. It's going to have to be a fairly long bridge, I think, to get a nice one. Oh, that works. I would like those pillars in the middle, but I'm not going to fuss with it too much. Can I get it to move at all? Answer, no, not really. Yep, that'll do. Oh, got a collision. Ah, no, still got a collision. Oh, come on. Behave. Seriously? Ah, that'll go in. I'll take it. I'll take it. I'm not going to be fussy. Now, where the hell was that going? It was going into there, wasn't it? All right. For now, we'll just throw it in like this. Because I just want it running. I'll sort out the optimizing these places later. Okay, so that's that running. Cool. Let's go back to this aircraft for a bit. Oh, look at that. They have done it. They've just done an absolutely fantastic job on the behaviour of the aircraft. But hang on a second. Why have you taken off? Where are you going? Hang on a second. Did I not finish the routes or something? Where's that plane? I can't see him now. Ah, I lost him. Where are we? Did I not finish the route? Because you just took off from... Oh, right. So it's going down this way. Oh, yeah. That's... It's not a fantastic route, is it? Going that way. Yeah. The clockwise route is way better than the anti-clockwise route. Okay, yeah, we'll still live with it. Be interesting to see what they do. Like, profits-wise, whether they actually, like, pick up any passengers, that kind of stuff. The other ones will have upgraded now, so let's have a quick look. Where are they? Oh, need to sort it by name. So, anti-clockwise and clockwise. Well, we'll see. We'll see if we actually start making any kind of profits. We've got zero passengers at the moment, which is kind of not a big surprise. All right, well, we'll see. That needs a whole load of optimization, but I just wanted to get the aircraft... the new airports in. That was kind of the main thing. Have I actually upgraded all of them to two runways? That's two runways. That's two runways. I did dogging, yeah, because I struggled with it. And RAF Halton. Did I put two runways? Yes, I did. Okay, so that's the airports done. God. Let's pause for a second. Because I need to figure out what I'm going to do next. And I think we're going to do some optimization. We'll do this, and then we'll do some optimization on the production chains, I think.